Hey guys, welcome back to the Brick Corner. Today we have another LEGO Star Wars review, and it is the Death Star Cannon, set number 75246 with 159 pieces. This set was released in 2020. Here's the back. As you can see, it's the Death Star Cannon. It comes with two minifigures. We have a Death Star, what do they call it? Death Star, I guess, cannon controller, and Obi-Wan Kenobi. So let's open it and see what's inside. All right, so inside we have two bags and an instruction booklet. A little small one. All right, let's get into it. So here is the finished Death Star cannon build. You will start with the build itself. Well, actually, we'll start with this. An extra little spring-loaded shooter cannon blaster bolt thing, which goes into here. As you can see, there's already one in here, so you get two of them. Boom! That's how a spring-loaded shooter works, if you didn't know already, and it shoots out green lasers. This is the Death Star cannon right here itself. There's this little turning mechanism, which doesn't do anything at all. It's just how it's done in the movies. You turn this and you can kind of move it with it. Again, on the just turning on its own doesn't do anything. As you can see, I'll move this around and turn it, doesn't do anything. Or turning it by itself doesn't do anything. But you can pretend to turn it as you are moving the cannon around, which is a nice fun little detail that they added to this set. So here's the kind of frame to the cannon. This is, I guess, supposed to be the outside of the Death Star here. And this is the inside where the cannon is, and it's shooting out. The cannon looks beautiful, as it should, because it is the main focus. Move it around so we can see it here. So we have like these two little cannon parts that look really nice. This is shooting something out, or just shooting something out. And the angles look beautiful. It starts very thin and then grows into this big bulky mechanism here. This translucent red piece with the gray piece on top of it just adds so much menacing detail to it. Makes it look so much nicer. And this thing swivels nicely. It has a nice radius, as you can see. You can turn all the way around to there and all the way back to there. It should just be able to turn within here, but within the little window, but I guess LEGO just decided, you know, we'll just have it turn all the way around like that. And so on this side, this is kind of like where the cannon driver will sit, and he'll shoot out like so. And it also moves up and down like that. So you can shoot down, around, everywhere within this little window. Here is the here's the part where Obi-Wan Kenobi disables the tractor beam in A New Hope. As you can see, there's a little lever here. He pulls down and makes that sound. That's like it's turning off. That's a fun little detail. And then there's this, which comes out, and you can kind of put it up like that. So that's like the tractor beam, and he disabling it, I guess, like so. And so that's a fun little detail they add. Very clever design. You just pull it out, and it fits nicely within the tube. And then there's a turned off tractor beam. A little printed control pad right there. As you can see, right there. A little red translucent piece to kind of show that there's a bunch of lights and mechanisms that are happening within here. Again, this right here is what you pull to release this. So if you want it to stand out, if you want the tractor beam to be on, you push it in and the tractor beam will be on. Then when you want to turn it off, you pull this out, push this down, and it's off. And that's pretty much the whole build of the set. So now we'll move on to the minifigures. So here are the minifigures. On the left, as you can see, we have Obi-Wan Kenobi, and on the right, we have the Death Star Cannon Controller. Let's start with the Death Star Cannon Controller. So he has this super awesome helmet right here with a Imperial insignia. Super awesome. The mold is amazing. Looks just like how it is in the movies. Only problem I have with it is, if you put it on, you kind of see a little bit of skin there. They used a black head, or they just partially made printed the head as black. Then it would have covered up that flesh and made it that much better. But honestly, it doesn't really that matter. It doesn't matter that much, because when you are just looking at it straight on, it's pretty menacing. Looking at the face, just kind of a normal face. He has a little, what would you call that? A little headset microphone there, so he can talk with his superiors and see where he's supposed to fire. Pretty generic face. No second face, because, you know, he is under a helmet, so you don't really see this face anyways. Put the helmet back on. Well, actually, let's take it off so we can look at the torso. Torso is kind of like this armor, but not really armor, because since they're not really out in combat, they're not getting shot at as much. They just kind of have this cloth uniform here, a belt that carries on to the back here. It's a black belt, carries to the back, and just more of the cloth uniform here. You can see the wrinkles and another kind of straps that are holding it up, and another part that goes around and holds it right there. And then that uniform is carried to the legs. Some nice leg printing. And this guy wields a blaster pistol. One of the old ones. Super nice. Glad it wasn't a what do you call them? Stud shooters. I'm glad they're just, you know, on these non-battle pack sets, they're just still putting on the old Lego guns. They look really nice. Now moving on to Obi-Wan Kenobi, who's looking good as always. Awesome new robe piece. Kind of has it come down and look like it's more attached to the cape that he has on, so it just flows better. Long, big cape, brown right there, super nice, matches the hood. We'll look at his face. So he just has a normal kind of smirk, a little grin. He doesn't have a second face, not quite sure why. I guess he doesn't really make any other face in the Death Star. He's not really that worried ever. Pretty cocky guy. But yeah, that's just his face. Nice gray beard, some cheekbones in his eyes, and his, you know, gray hair. Then we move on to his robes. As you can see underneath, there's some brown robing, which is covered up by a light beige robe here, which is held together by a belt, which, look back, is carried throughout the back. There's also some more robe printing on the back there. And no robe printing on the legs, which I'm a little surprised by. But, you know, it is a cheap set. It's only $20. You get two pretty nice minifigures right here, as you can see. So, $20 is pretty much worth it. So, here's the lightsaber. Blue. Standard Obi-Wan's lightsaber. So, here is the set as a whole. If you've watched the movie, there isn't really a canon where the tractor beam generator is, but I guess this is a way to tie into small sets they could have made, because if they had just made this, I think it'd be a little bit too small. And again, this is just a super nice cannon. So although they're not in the same scene, it's kind of like two little mini sets within one. So here, this I have a little problem with this thing because it's when you put it in, it doesn't really stand up straight because it has a kind of like crescent sphere bottom, so it doesn't really like stand up straight, which is unfortunate. But that's something to look past. It's easy to look past. But yeah, this set is pretty nice. Super cheap, like I said, only $20. Lego's really churning out these nice $20 sets, great minifigures, and cool little detailed scenes these past couple years. So I really enjoyed that. I think I got this on sale, and I believe it's on sale right now on Amazon. So there's a link in the description if you'd like to buy this one for yourself. It's only, I think, $17 right now. So if you want to buy this, there will be a link in the description to purchase it for yourself. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys later. Bye.